Hi everyone, and welcome to our Home for Christmas digital kit release. What a beautiful kit this is. The warmth and the color and everything about this kit is really going to convey Christmas to you. It has all the joy, all the traditional things that Christmas represents, plus it has that beautiful home scene that gives you all that warmth and memories in your heart. This is our bundled collection, and in our bundled collection, for those of you that are new to us, you do receive 5 products, which is the entire coordinated collection, which includes our FQB kit, our Home for Christmas 2 paper pack, our Home for Christmas Alpha, our Home for Christmas Solids pack, and our Home for Christmas Little Bits Additional Elements pack. So when you purchase this as a bundle, you do save 20% versus purchasing these items individually. And trust me, it's well worth it. It is such a great kit. You're going to have so many things you're going to want to make with this. From Christmas cards, maybe Christmas tags, maybe you want to use it as a little bit of wrapping paper if you have small gifts, things like that. You are going to love it. So let's go in and have a peek here so that you can see everything that this kit offers you. Great banners. You'll see how I used one of these in my card making idea towards the end when I show you the inspiration things. But they are fabulous to use to add a little bit of color, a little bit of inspiration, and a little bit of words in there. You can see how they are so easy to use, just kind of up in those corner areas or areas that may be a little bit, you want to just give it a little more pizzazz or whatever. These are perfect for that. The background papers, as you're going to see, have beautiful traditional color tones. There is some beiges, some greens, obviously the rich red. Really evokes Christmas. And the warmth of this kit, as I mentioned to you earlier, really is something else. You can see with the holly background, there is so many traditional things in here. But here you are in the green holly, which has a more almost toile-like pattern to it, where it's all in nice whites and stuff instead of color. So you have the option to go very, very upscale and mature and things like that, a little more elegant in any of your creations that you decide to go with. There's the plaid. Like I said to you earlier, wouldn't that be a great thing if you had a small gift to print that off and use that as wrapping paper? What a beautiful color and a great pattern. Obviously, lots of different colors in things because we don't know what color palette you want to choose, so we want to make sure you have them. Poinsettia papers. Again, just beautiful. You can see the different hues in there. There's a dark version if you like that. The bold green. Just really, really super Christmas oriented. There it is in the red. And as I said earlier, I know I kind of am a broken record here, but it really is Christmas. It's everything you think of when you think of Christmas in your mind. You think of that rich, warm memories. And here is the scene. Now, this should give you tons of inspiration. When you see that beautiful snowflake, the swirls in here that make it look like the wind is blowing and the snow is blowing, and then that great house, everything looks so cozy in the snow. I hope you can see this. This could easily be a wonderful Christmas card, a wonderful beginning to a layout. There's so many options here. But that gives you a taste of what you can create with it. Again, lots of different patterns, lots of different colors, so that you have so many options for you. Here is the other option, and this is what I was saying about going to a more elegant, a more refined kind of look. This stationery back here in the FQB, like, look at the beauty of that. With those intricate snowflakes, the grouping of the poinsettias, and the cluster and the bouquet, basically, of the poinsettias in this wonderful tone of a cream color. Really, again, as a starting spot where you think, okay, I need a main paper or I need something to kind of give me some vision here. Here it is, right in one paper already. Some stripes as well, because obviously those go so well with everything else. We want to have lots of patterns and textures, some simple, some a little more intricate, so that you can pair those easily together. And into the twills. The twills are, again, a great thing where it just gives you that little bit of texture. Just a little hint of those papers gives it such life and such interest in your cards and layouts. Beautiful bows in that grosgrain kind of ribbon, almost realistic looking to give you that real feel. Some vintage buttons. Aren't those just great where they look like they've been chipped and worn? And again, the colors that are just so easy to match into this kit. That's kind of the point of it all. Candy canes, obviously, Christmas comes with candy canes. We have them all over the house. I don't know about you guys, but there's constantly one being unwrapped. Mary Fran made a card front here. So again, may the magic of Christmas fill each corner of your heart and home. Beautiful, just gorgeous. Everything's already done for you. So whether you want to slide that in as an additional element into your cards and layouts or use it in its entirety, how easy is that to make your Christmas cards for the year? Simply turn that and print it out, and print it as many times as you want, and off you go. Fill in the insides and you've got Christmas cards this year. Corner cluster, we've given it to you in its raw format, so that way you can place it wherever you want onto a background paper or whatever. And all of this in behind is opaque. So when you are putting it onto a background paper or putting, maybe you have some other elements that you want, something tucked underneath it, all you do is you put that element down first, you put this one over top, and when you go to print it, if you're not creating digitally, if you're creating and printing and crafting in physical paper, as I know a lot of you do, and we do a lot of that as well, you simply put down your first element that's underneath, you put this over the top, and you print it as one. So then you have exactly the element that you want. A great countdown card for Santa down to the 25th. We all know when Santa comes. That's not a day that we miss. Great frames here. Again, you can use these for photos. You can use these and put main elements in behind. You could put in simply a background paper in behind here that gives you such interest and texture. Put a little label on the front. You'll see some labels coming up later in the kit here. There you go. You have a wonderful card, layout, area, anything, right? There's the house in its individual element form. So that way, again, we want to give you creative control where you can place that wherever you want and get exactly the look you're looking at. But look at how wonderfully Mary Fran has done this. Curtains in the windows, shadowing where the snow and the eaves are, and beautiful trees, obviously, to complement it all. Here's some journaling labels for you. Obviously lined already. Great gift tags. Hint, hint. All you have to do is punch a little hole. If you have a hole punch, punch a little hole in there so you can have a ribbon to tie on or simply tape it onto the present, whatever works for you. Again, another one, Noel. Here's a beautiful one. Again, if you're giving to someone, this is a nice vintage look. See the worn lines in here and things like that. You want to have that ability in order to go in that direction. There's that beautiful home again with the swirls and the wind and the snowflakes, all done up in a gift tag type format for you. Journal papers. So again, these are so fabulous to use. Christmas is chock full of memories, and also for the Christmas gift giving and card giving, what a wonderful insert to put into the card. It gives you so much more room to write because it's lined. You know, you keep your printing and your writing straight. I don't know if you have that same problem, but I really do. It looks like, you know, it's all over the place. So we certainly make these are awesome things in order to print off and insert into your card, whether you paste it in or it's a loose format, whatever you want. A great vintage candy cane label. Fabulous item again in order to add. You'll see how Mary Fran used this in her layout inspiration. There's the lantern just by itself. Obviously a big part of home is bringing everybody home with the light there. Photo prongs so that you can clip down your photos if that's the way you want to use them. Great phrase strips. And this is what I was talking about, maybe layering underneath that corner cluster of the poinsettias we were talking about earlier. All roads lead to home at Christmas, peace, love, and joy. Friends and family are the true gifts at Christmas time. Use these tags, folks. These are so wonderfully done with the beautiful font work and everything else. So easy to pop into your cards and layouts and actually say what you want to say. Just a terrific, terrific element to use. Poinsettia clusters in their individual form, again, so that you have creative control and do whatever you want with them. Postcards. If there isn't a time for cards, it's Christmas time, right? Again, a wonderful thing that you could use as your Christmas card. Look at how beautiful that is. We all go shopping and looking for those very unique, personalized cards. Why not just use something like that? It is so easy to do. Lots of ribbons in this kit because we know you want to pair things in. I'll show you again and point it out when we get to the layout and the card at the end of this video, how we've used those so you can get a little bit of inspiration on them. Merry Christmas and Happy Christmas. We know that obviously there's a few different connotations and way of, or vernaculars of how people account for Christmas, so we want to make sure they're both in there. Great snowflakes in these circles. Again, you'll see how I use one of these in my card making idea. You'll see how wonderfully they turn out. They give such great interest because of the intricacy of the snowflake. Good wishes to you throughout the year. Another great tag, whether you want to use that as a tag in your layouts and cards, obviously, or again, use it as a gift tag or add it in just as a great item, and I'll show it to you on Mary Fran's layout, a great item just to add some interest. Here's some word strips again. Hopefully they have sentiments that are things that you were looking to say, but if not, we do include some blanks because we realize that not everybody has English as their primary language, and as well, we may not have said what you wanted, so we want to make sure and encompass that. Our Little Bits Additional Elements Pack, another great cluster and another great item to use as a card front or to use as a wonderful element to spotlight on your cards and your layouts. A great full tag that gives you a great emotion in the joy word there. And see how Mary Fran even wove the ribbon through it? It looks like it's, you know, woven right through it, like it lays over those letters. Great job, great job. Another great cluster. Our Little Bits is chock full of items that you can just easily use. That way, if you're a little pressed for time, as we all are at Christmas time, we want to make sure that you have the items that you can quickly put together a card or a layout or whatever without having to do all the creating with the individual parts and pieces. Here's a great Christmas sentiment, which is used like a digital stamp. So you use this just as you would an ink stamp, like so many of you are use. This is digital, so then that way you can place it on anything you want. Same thing in the Happy Christmas format. Great sentiment cards, so that way you can include whatever phrase, whatever emotion, whatever name, date, whatever it is you want to put in there, we have those available. Send another few sentiment labels, so in case, again, you can just pop these in. Christmas waves a magic wand over the world, and behold, everything is softer and more beautiful. So you can easily place those tags in so that it is so simple and quick to create. Then that's kind of what we want to do when we include our Little Bits in our kits. So there's the full Little Bits. Our Christmas 2 is an additional paper pack. There are not duplicates in this. I don't want you to think that you're getting duplicate papers and it's not worth buying for you. You will see, you've seen these patterns before, but you haven't seen them in these colors. I know that when you get a kit that you love, you really want to create and create and create with it. And this is the point of this. Or even if you use it this year and then you use it again next year. You want things to be different. You don't want them to be all identical and things like that and have to basically reusing the same thing over and over again. And that is the point of having our two paper pack, is we want to make sure that you get so many options and so many availabilities so that everything can be different, but yet still all flows together. The solids, again, we use these just like you would cardstock, but these are the perfectly color matched ones for you. As you can see, there's a beautiful border around the edge of each one. So these are great standalone papers. Don't mistake these. Imagine taking this and putting on that digital stamp sentiment with the Merry Christmas or Happy Christmas on here, having the house scene or the corner cluster of the flowers. There you go. You've created your own custom paper that you can utilize yourself. But you can also use these to back your main elements, because I know that's a very popular thing. Give them a little more sturdiness, but also a little more color and enhance the color on them, or backing photos. So you have the option with perfectly color matched, basically digital cardstock. And lastly is our alpha, a fantastic alpha, which you can see has the very mature vintagey theme to it, gives you all the letters and numbers in order and some punctuation in order to create and spell things out on your cards and layouts. Maybe it's a name, maybe it's a date, maybe you want to spell Merry Christmas or Happy Christmas in big file format. Here you have it in the letters. But don't mistake, use this for so many things. This, an alpha can be used for just immeasurable things. Your imagination is the only limitation. But really, if you haven't used our alphas before, that's your challenge for this year, is go ahead, use the alpha and see how you can enhance your layouts and cards with this. Because it really, really does. So that is the kit in its soul and totality. Now let's give you a little inspiration here. Mary Fran's layout, as I was mentioning earlier, she really is the queen of pairing things together. She has great eye for scale and color. But here's how some of those cards were used. See how they add in just interest at the bottom here? Obviously, it's the home. It's the feeling of us in the home, that kind of stuff at Christmas time. But as you can see, she's used the ribbons. See how they just made a great little backing to the Happy Christmas tag as well. There's the snowflake tag up at the top. There's the individual poinsettia. There's how she chose to use the photo prongs. So photo prongs are not for photos only. They're great just to hold down main elements like this card, things like that. So hopefully that gives you a start and some inspiration as to how to use some of the elements. And secondly is my card. And there you go. This is what I was talking about. See how beautifully that snowflake adds a real level of elegance in order to the card. Obviously, I've used the poinsettia in here and tried to go a little more upscale in the card, a little more color, a little more punch to it. And there again is how I used those banners. That's what I was talking about, is if you take that banner out, it's still a decent card and because we have the paper underneath. But in order for it to not to be plain and I give it a little bit more life, that's how I chose to use that. So folks, that is our Home for Christmas collection. We hope that you will enjoy this kit and also enjoy Christmas. Enjoy creating for it. Enjoy everything in it. The baking, the memories, the decorating, the people you surround yourself with. And that was the kind of whole theme and thought behind making a Home for Christmas collection. Thanks for tuning in, but before you leave, please look down into the right corner of the screen here in the bottom right. You'll see our Nitwit Collections logo. Click on that to be subscribed to our channel so that you'll always be made aware when new videos come out so you won't miss a thing. And give us the thumbs up if you like the video and also leave us a message. Tell us how you're going to use this kit. Let us know your thoughts on it. If you have any questions, anything like that, you're more than welcome to leave them in there. Thanks once again, and we hope that you have a wonderful home for Christmas too.